In this episode of the Grinding Chronicles, we're going to talk all about fluting and the various factors you should consider when you're trying to optimize your grinding process.
Welcome to the Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Product Engineer, who we call the Q Prime Titan, also known as Thi Dang.
Hi, I'm Thi Dang, Product Engineer at Continental Diamond Tool. One of the first things that comes to mind when you think about grinding is speeds and feeds, with good reason. Speed and feed rate are two of the most important cutting parameters in grinding, and they play a big part in optimizing your process.
Q Prime is the most practical measure of performance in grinding. So what is it exactly? Simply put, Q Prime is the material mill rate and is calculated by multiplying the depth of cut by the feed rate. Higher Q Prime values mean shorter cycle times. You also want a high G ratio, removing a larger amount of material with less wheel wear. This measurement really looks at efficiency. It's calculated by dividing the volume of material removed from a workpiece by the volume of wheel wear. When selecting wheel speed, you'll want to consider these factors. And remember, faster doesn't necessarily mean better. Operating at higher speeds, for example, can increase wheel wear due to high temperatures. So it's all about finding the optimal range to grind for your material and application. Other factors that have nothing to do with the grinding wheel, such as stiffness, setup, spindle power, and coolant delivery, can affect performance as well. If your machine has low power or poor coolant delivery, for example, your G ratio and Q prime ceiling may be lower, limiting your grinding potential. To fully appreciate where we are today in flute grinding, we can look at the history of Bond technology and their maximum Q prime values. In 1965, we had wheels with phenolic resin bonds, and the Q prime value was about 3. Then in 1970, with polyimide bonds, we began seeing values around 5. By 2000, Q prime increased to approximately 7 with hybrid bonds. Today, we're capable of removing material at rates between 10 and 15.
To achieve rates over 10, you would need the latest hybrid bond technology, such as CDT's EVO Hybrid Bond, which became available earlier this year. EVO is a customized bond designed specifically for the cutting tools industry. The first generation fluting wheels at CDT was not capable of such high Q prime. Our goal was to create a wheel that was grinding aggressively with minimal wear and excellent corner retention. It was important to design a bond system that would transfer heat away from the part. The reason is that diamond is very sensitive to heat. At the point of grind, the heat gets too hot. It turns back to carbon, which results in wear of the wheel. We knew we need thermally conductive material to extract that heat away from the part. So we started thinking outside the box and utilized material not ordinarily used in this application. With our grinding lab, we ran tests and generated data to help us to optimize the process. We went through about 12 iterations of this particular bond before finalizing the formula. The EVO Hybrid Bond offers high Q prime without compromising G ratio compared to competitor products and even earlier products of our own. The EVO Hybrid is far superior.
If you're interested in seeing if the EVO Hybrid Bond series would benefit your operation, or if you have questions about optimizing your grinding process, we'd love to help. To reach out, send us an email at thegrindingchronicles@cdtusa.net.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tool.